as we can see two brand new rear tyres on the back, still sticker tyres on the CRC number 54 machine of Brad Mosen. So 10-time New Zealand Midget Car Champion there of Michael Pickens, newly crowned 1NZ Midget Car Champion in the Greenway Total Access machine of Mosen off the front row. And then a returnee to open wheel midget car racing, Hayden Williams, for Suzanne and Jeff Harper in the HLR racing machine here. So it looks like we're going to try and go four wide here as we slot drivers in and the door opens for Hayden Williams to sneak through there. So as we get these drivers in position for the four wide salute, give them a salute, ladies and gentlemen, as they drive past you. Put your hands together for some of the finest open wheel midget car drivers in the country. A welcome return, as we say, to Hayden Williams here. As we get fired up for one of the prestigious races here of the season, the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix. As they drive past, put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. They can see you from the cockpit, and they'll appreciate that as they get set to tear it up around Luxor Western Springs Speedway for 25 laps, putting on the race of their lives. So as they grid up in position, running through those grids, the 54, the 1NZ, 87, 97, 2NZ, 3NZ, 9A, 7K, 63M, 71A, 73K, 34A, 9M, 41P, 35A, 93P, 21M, 94A, 4A, and 77K. So as the Mahindra Scorpio pace vehicle pulls to the inside, we get set for the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix. Roll around turn number three here at Luxor Western Springs Speedway, the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix. It's Pickens versus Mosen, and Mosen's gonna take the initial jump. He drops down to that pole line, sliding up the racetrack as Morrison gets all out of shape, and Pickens big up and over at minus turn number two, and that is going to be retirement for the CRC number 54 on the opening lap of the Grand Prix. So, and just like that, ladies and gentlemen, one of the top contenders and certainly the top pick for most here for the Grand Prix, Pickens with a big tumble. Right in front of the corporate hospitality suite down there at turn two. Heavy damage there to the upper left-hand corner there as we see Michael moving around in the cockpit. What we like to see, but certainly by the clumps of clay there down at turn two, big up and over. So ladies and gentlemen, he's out of the car. Put your hands together for Michael Pickens as he gets out. So great to see, just as we've been talking about, the testament of how good the safety equipment is in these race cars and the equipment that these drivers wear. Great to see Michael up and out of that car, and he's got a little lip on there as well, so certainly with 50 laps still ahead of the sprint car later on, it's not looking good for the 54 as he walks to the infield. So St. John team down there will be checking out Pickens to make sure he's a-okay, but certainly not how you'd be wanting to start the J.R. Russell Marley Springs Royale coming up later on as he gets into the soldered cartage side by side. So as we look to the big screen, ladies and gentlemen, watch the CRC machine high and wide launches over that rut wheel stand, and it looked like it was actually initiated from the front end. Looked like the left front got that rut, and that helped kind of slingshot the front end of wheel stand and head into that tumble. So nasty there is. Certainly looks like there's some considerable damage to that race car, and not what we like to see. Race cars can be fixed, but great to see Michael Pickens walking away from that car somewhat unscathed. So certainly one of the top picks for this one gone out of the mix, and that throws it open because Mosen now with the front row all to himself. And I tell you what, as much as we love these drivey, fast racetracks, it certainly makes for heavy tumbles when they go up and over just by the extra grip in the racetrack. And exit stage right there for Michael Pickens. So now the Greenway Total Access 1NZ off Brad Mosen with the front row to himself, with one of the hot contenders out of this. And that leaves clear track in front for the 87 of Hayden Williams here. Morrison was all up and out of shape down at turn number two as well on that opening lap. A lot of that was just avoiding action to try and navigate through on Pickens. So Mosen, lights are out. What can he deliver here on the restart here? Still 25 laps left to run here for the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix. So Mosen, our pace setter off the front row with the row to himself. Hayden Williams trying to sneak up the inside. Can he get a run on Mosen? We're about to find out. Looks like Mosen's going to have the front row all to himself. Little wheel stand there for Hayden Williams in contact with that of Morrison. But they settle into a bit of a groove, and the Auto Super Shop's number 87 moves into the second spot, hanging on to that. Mosen now clearing out already on the second place driver. All drivers managing to get through. Aaron Hodgson already moved up a handful of positions, so the Carter's tyres, number 35 on a mission, trying to work his way forward. So Alan Kinsley and Aaron Hodgson, the big movers at this point in time, as Brad Mosen goes right up nice and close to the wall. Hayden Williams leaves the door open for Ben Morrison. That allows the 97 Brinklab machine through. So has Ben Morrison got some legs for Brad Mosen? He's got a featured win under his belt already this season. As we keep an eye on the youngster in his rookie season in Midget Car Racing, running second to the Greenway 1NZ driver currently leading this. Mosen right up against the wall down at Pernright turn number 3 and 4. As is Aaron Hodgson trying to go the long way, trying to work their way through the racetrack. Drivers starting to separate a little bit, spreading out throughout the field. Certainly looks like that right side of the race car suits the softer Ben Morrison, just allows him to load the right rear a little bit harder. No doubt a softer right rear bar than that car than that of Mosen. So he's definitely working that car super hard, but high risk, high reward for Ben Morrison, still running in second behind this man, the Greenway 1NZ. Almost into the lap traffic as Morrison flips the rut down in turn number two. Still Hayden Williams running in third from the 2NZ of Brock Maskevich. Then it's the battle of the youngsters. Trentway, Mitch Favish, Alec Insley, Matthews, and Aaron Hodgson. So with only a lap until he's in lap traffic, Mosen is going to be on the back of Brent Curran, which is going to allow Ben Morrison to get a little bit closer. 8 laps in the book so far. Morrison now moves high side, trying to find some extra racetrack with Mosen. Mosen tries to go high side. He's trying to clean that racetrack. Up against walls, we've got one up and over down to turn number one, and it's a 35 of Aaron Hodgson. So heavy contact there once again for the front end of Aaron Hodgson. It has not been his night tonight, with two tumbles here. And unfortunately, that's going to be the end of the 35 Carter's tyres machine. So we've got a replay of this, so we'll keep our eyes on the big screen to see how this prevails. So there's the top car in shot there, the white and baby blue machine of Aaron Hodgson. So we'll wait for that replay to come, but great to see once again Hodge getting out of that race car. There's the tail end of it there. Might have managed to keep it off the wall, but there we go. So the car actually straightens up. What happens here? It looks like something's broken in that front end for sure. Definitely a steering component failure there in the Carter's number 35, because that was none of Aaron's doing there whatsoever as well. So that car just straightened up and just did straight into the wall, and he was a passenger from that moment on. So we'll wait to see as that race car comes to the infield. Graham Standring's down on the infield. I'm not too sure if he had a chance to see any of that prevail, but no doubt as that car comes to the infield, Graham will be able to get a closer look for us. contact there with that front end for Aaron Hodgson, and we thought he managed to actually keep it off the wall prior to seeing that replay, but far from it, as he was trying to steer that race car, and just nothing was happening. So very sad looking spike SR11X. So we'll wait and see if we manage to get a word with Aaron at any point. He's down in the bunker down at Pine Tree Bend, so far enough away from Graham's stand drink to not have to have a word to Graham. And no doubt very dejected Aaron Hodgson, understandably so. So it looks like we're still going to go another lap here, and certainly some real pace out of the print lab number 97. So wait and see to what he has for Brad Mose in the 3NZ, now up on the outside of the second row as well. So Mitch Babbitt made up a couple of spots here. Hodgson was on a big move along with Alec Insley. So yeah, Alec Insley now up into the seventh spot as well. So Alec Insley moved up three spots and managing to get his way a little bit further forward. So the lights are out once again as we're near on double digits here for the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix. Drivers roll past the cone, full control of Brad Mosen here. Leaves it a little bit late, and here comes the attack from Morrison. Goes side by side down the front stretch, but the lead is going to go to Mosen as they both hit through that rut on the pole line, and both get it down coming out of two as they make contact. Williams goes through up the inside of Brad Mosen. It's all on here. Big bike for Mosen coming out of turn number four. That leaves the door open for the 87. Here comes the return of Hayden Williams. Mosen with a run coming out of Pine Tree. Big contact, big hit at the wall with the 3NZ of Mitch Babbitt. My oh my. That was awkward to say the least there for the 3NZ of Mitch Babbitt. The way that car launched to the wall, virtually top first. Not something you like to see here. We were just saying about the progress of Mitch Babbitt and how well he was doing, but certainly the tackiness and roughness down there on that pole line, that rut catching out several drivers, including that of Ben Morrison and Brad Mosen on previous laps. Great to see Mitch moving inside that race car. Once again, that down tube on that race car is absolute junk on that right-hand side. And great to see Mitch moving around, but that's a very sad-looking race car. As we take a look on the big screen and watch it go straight into the concrete wall there, just straight on that down tube. And you see a front spring sitting there. And ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Mitch Babbitt is out of the car. Your current 3NZ. And I tell you what, I know we've got Graham Standrick down in the bunker, and that was a nasty incident, the way that that car violently hit the wall there with the down tube, Graham.
Yeah, he did, and it looks like he rode a wheel. So he was just going around the outside of somebody, making really good progress. He'd been moving through the field on the outside line. He just picked up a right rear. So when the cars ride what we call ride a wheel, they climb up over the wheel of the car in front, any of the left or right-hand wheels, man, you just go for the wall as fast as you would believe. So that's what happened to Mitch, unfortunately. Shame for him. He was actually progressing very, very well.
Yeah, and that car went from looking like a high bar car, Graham, to more like what you used to drive as a low bar car, the way that that down tube's looking. So not what you like to see. And as we say, great just to see Mitch getting out of that race car and moving and under his own steam coming to the infield. So he'll be getting checked out, and yeah, not what we like to see. But I tell you what, the driver who took exact advantage of the misdemeanors and incidentals there of the drivers at the pointy end of Mosen and Morrison, Hayden Williams on the absolute charge. someone who was going to be excited about that is the two individuals up here in the booth, the David Turner and Nick Brown, are going to be ecstatic seeing the return of the 87 to form. So the lights are out and we get set to turn them loose once again. Mosen and Williams is your front row.
I'm standing down here with two guys and two wrecked cars. It's real a shame. First and foremost, Aaron, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Yep, nothing to it.
And Michael, I saw you limping away there. How are you feeling?
Yeah, all right. I've had a bit of nights, but I'll try and sit down and rest and get back in the sprint car later on.
Yeah, I hope a bit of time would help, but cars look, both of them look pretty bad. In particular, even the Mitch Fabish car down tube crushed. Yours is pretty wrecked up too. It looked like your car went straight into the wall, straight ahead.
Yeah, I'm not, something's let go. A caliper broke off it as well, so I couldn't really slow it up. So it's pretty, yeah, I think it's pretty pretty rooted.
Okay, well, good luck for the rest of the racing around the country, and yeah, you're all good. So that, I'm not sure what's happened up there, but yeah, let's hope you go and get ready for the sprint car race.
Yeah, thank you, appreciate it.
You've got some big fans, some Australians up there that just think that you walk on water, so there you go.
That's awesome, appreciate the support, guys.
Okay, thanks, guys. Oh, just going to get Mitch Favish. Mitch? Mitch, yeah, did you ride a wheel? Is that what happened?
Yeah, I caught the old dirty old right rear. Sucks because we were fast in that feature there. Yeah, I'm just gutted for my guys to have that happen, but yeah, is what it is.
Yeah, I saw you making real good progress around the top. I thought, oh, you know, I was starting to, like, he's on it. So yeah, pretty good. I see your car's a bit of a mess though.
Yeah, car's a bit of a mess, but 2 minute of race cars keep me safe, which is the main thing.
Mosen goes earlier this time, leaves Williams napping a little bit. Morrison gets into the side of Williams on the restart, but Williams now tries to go up the inside of Mosen down at turn number one. Mosen closes the door. Already the front two have already stretched out a little bit on Morrison in the print lab number 97. Let's keep an eye on this one. The engine under the hood, only one generation older than that of the equipment in the front and behind Williams as well. So let's wait and see, can Williams prevail to not only hang on to the second, but also take the fight to that of Brad Mosen. Certainly looks like he's got plenty of power under that right foot of the bullet spike machine. So Morrison just jumps the cushion there at turn number one and two and loses a little bit of ground on Williams. Then we go back to the Langlo Engineering number nine of Trent Way, currently running in the fourth spot. So now Mosen and Williams virtually shadowing and ghosting each other as we've got one right up against the wall, keeps it off the wall as we see Ben Matthews just slow down and pull to the infield. So that was Jaden Baslay right up against the concrete wall down at turns number one and two. Manages to just keep it off and keep it racing as we see the nine of Trent Way doing all kinds of battle down there on the pole line, trying to keep Maskevich and the R&R Malam 2NZ behind him as McDonnell tries to go high side around the outside of the 2NZ machine. The two kings of running on the pole line, Trent Way and Brock Maskevich. Mosen and Hayden Williams putting on an absolute doozy of a show, running right up against the wall all the way around Lucasaw Western Spring Speedway. Doing a great job. Ben Morrison still running in the third spot, Trentway fourth, Brock Maskevich in fifth. Then we go back to Jordan McDonnell. Now we've got Peter Honeybell and the teammate Campbell Stewart right in there as well. So they're duking it out as McDonnell manages to find the wall, getting down the front stretch. With nine laps left to run, as Hayden Williams starts to pull in our leader, Brad Mosen. So what are we going to see at the pointy end of this one, as these two gun drivers find themselves into the lap traffic? We're not far away from finding out as the laps tick down here. Mosen right in the thick of heat of battle with Hayden Williams. Williams just urging closer and closer. Lap on lap, third position well locked in for Ben Morrison at this point in time. Only a couple of seconds time, Mosen is going to be right on the tail. Take a break, current, that slows down Mosen. Can Hayden Williams close up and take advantage? We're about to find out. He's right there as we see Campbell Stewart pulled to the infield. And just like that, the yellow flag is out for Jordan McDonnell down at turn number three. I think it's fair to say with that absolutely saved Brad Mosen. With only seven laps left to come, that traffic there was not what Mosen needed, and that just gave everything to Hayden Williams to be able to close up. Certainly didn't look like Mosen had too much more fight left in him, or was he just holding a little bit in reserve? With only seven laps left to run, I think it's fair to say anything can happen here. Nick Brown, you saw that unfold, mate. That was getting super exciting.
It was, but I did notice that Brad Mosen just got past the 77K, and the 77K just put slowed down Hayden Williams just a little bit. If the yellow hadn't come up, I'm predicting that Brad would have just powered away from that, and we would have seen a real ding-dong battle bringing it down to the last probably two or three laps, and that's when you can't pick it. Hayden was coming on really strong, starting to reel him in, and now we've got a restart. Everything could go out the window on this one.
Yeah, you're not wrong. And I tell you what, I'm super impressed by the return to form from Hayden Williams. Like, he's been out of the car for a couple of seasons. He's got a couple of shows under his belt already this year, running, a car for Shane Snooks and whatnot as well. But, you know, as far as packages go, it's not a brand new car. It's not a brand new engine. And it's fair to say that that package that Brad Mosen's got is virtually the best you can get in the business.
Absolutely, but Hayden's had a little bit of experience in Australia driving other cars that he's for other teams that haven't always been like brand new, and he's stepped into them and got to grips with them quite quickly. So the learning curve that Hayden's got and can use, find the envelope in which the car and the machinery works, he can find that quite quickly.
There we go, as we get set to go green, and we are racing for seven more laps for the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix. Hayden Williams now right on the back of Brad Mosen. Here he is up the inside, catches Mosen off guard, slides up the inside. Can Mosen go the long way around? He clears him. So Mosen back to the front. Hayden Williams, has he got anything to give? Here comes the number two NZ of Brock Maskevich up the inside of Ben Morrison. Morrison prevails, but at the front, it's Mosen still hanging on from Williams. Five more laps left to run for Brad Mosen. He's got that one NZ on the tail tank for a good reason. He had plenty left up his sleeve, clearly, when Williams was flowing right in there. He still had a little bit left under his right foot, and he's proven why he is the gun driver for the Greenway team. Brad Mosen clearing out now from Williams. Mosen knows that he's right there, and he's maximizing that Greenway total access one NZ to its absolute limit as Morrison tries to have a swing at Hayden Williams. But has Mosen got anything left to hold off the charge from Hayden Williams in the last couple of laps? So far, so good, but he's got a couple of laps left to run. Morrison having another swing at Hayden Williams down to turns 3 and 4. Still a battle further back for 4th and 5th with Brock Maskevich and Trent Way. Jaden Baslay doing a great job in there as well, up into the 6th spot. But the white flag is out for our current running NZ, Brad Mosen. Can he bring it home for the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix? With only 2 more turns left to go for the Greenway driver, Brad Mosen running through turns 3 and 4 for the final time. What has Hayden Williams got? Brad Mosen is the winner of the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix. There you have it. Results on screen confirming victory. 1NZ, Brad Mosen takes the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix from the returning Hayden Williams. Ben Morrison with a stellar drive in third. Brock Maskevich, 2NZ in fourth. And Jaden Baslay brings home fifth.
What a great drive by Brad Mosen, particularly the attack that Hayden Williams put into him, and then driving right around the outside through turns 3 and 4, a spectacular drive. Ben Morrison coming in third place, and a great one for him. I'd love to talk to him later on about why he had the sledgehammer. But ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for Brad Mosen.
Brad Mosen, New Zealand Midget Car Champion, now New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix winner. Not a bad effort.
Thanks, Graham. Yeah. Did not need those restarts. The guys behind me, I mean, I felt like I was a sitting duck, but yeah, just managed to get straight to my line on those second, third, fourth, fifth, whichever restart it was, and it seemed to give me the run off a two and then the advantage into three. So guys out there behind me, you know, it's the pressure's on, but just feel bad. I saw some big wrecks in that race, so I hope everyone's all right. But well done to Ben, well done to Hayden. Awesome to have him back on the podium.
Okay, thanks again, ladies and gentlemen. Brad Mosen, winner of the New Zealand Midget Car Grand Prix.